Welcome to Moffice Collaboration, Approvals. What are approvals? They are digital documents that require permission from superiors. Users can even draft and process these electronically through the Moffice Suite platform. Approvals can even be accessed by mobile app and subsequently signed off from anywhere. Cut down on paperwork with an integrated digital permission platform system, Approval. In our video, we're first going to go over the approval process and learn about the terminologies used. Next, we'll go over the admin submenu for approval managers. Finally, we'll wrap up with how users can utilize approvals with user submenus. First, we'll go over how approvals work. There are two types of approvals available in Moffice Suite: agreement and implementation or execution approvals. Agreement approvals only need the agreed approval of selected superiors. We call the line of superiors the user may select on an internal approval route. Here's an example. On the other hand, implementation or execution approvals require the selection of an additional department after the final superior's confirmation. The additional department is called a processing department and will carry out the finalized decision. Thus, implementation approvals are used for actionable documents that will require a department to act upon their contents. Here's an example. Thus, as you'll notice in side-by-side comparisons, the one difference between agreement and implementation approvals is the utilization of the processing department for implementation approvals. Let's now talk about selecting approval routes. Generally, we think of approval routes as being hierarchical. Documents are sent to higher and higher superiors and offices. However, we do have a few other selections available. Job hierarchy is a sensitive subject, so getting multiple departments involved requires more finesse. First, going through our standard hierarchy type, users select a manager, and that manager selects their superior, and so forth. Most decision-making takes place in the same department. Likewise, we select users and can give them additional permissions to edit, the approval route, the document itself, and selected CC and reviewers. Now, for documents that require the collaboration of several departments working together, there are two options: interdepartmental required and interdepartmental optional. Both of these options involve the usage of various departments and can be set to each individual selected on a user's approval route. With the required option, the approval process requires the selected users to approve for a complete document. On the other hand, the optional selection means that the approval process can continue even without the explicit consent of that individual. Next, for both interdepartmental options, drafters can choose sequential or non-sequential processing. Sequential processing goes through each user in the order you selected for the approval route. Non-sequential processing does the opposite and allows the user to approve or reject the document as soon as you submit the draft, regardless of order. You'll also notice that you can add CC or referrers as well as reviewers. Selected users of either can only read your approval document without being a part of the approval process. There are a few key differences that we'll highlight to help you decide whether to CC a user or assign them as a reviewer. CC or referrers are users who can read your document from the moment you submit it until its approval process completes. Note that CC referrer recipients can view these drafts in their CC referrer folder in the approval for reference submenu. Reviewers, on the other hand, can only read the content of a document after the approval is completed. Until then, they may not read the document. Check any approvals that you have as the reader in the For My Review subfolder. Drafters can likewise confirm which documents they submitted that have reviewers in the For Others Review folder. For those registered as approval managers, a separate administrator menu will appear at the bottom of the main submenu list, highlighted in another color. Admin submenus help set up forms for approval form usage and other additional options. Through the All Forms submenu, admins can check all available HTML forms for users. Click the name of any form to view its contents. Managers may likewise delete and edit forms as necessary. Organize forms through sections. To do so, click More and then Form Sections. Here, you can use the file tree to add new folders or modify or delete existing folders. Note that common folders are there by default. In addition, click More, then Sample Forms to download new sample forms to your Moffice Suite. Note that you'll need to tweak some labels and text to customize the form for your company. To make your own, simply utilize the pencil icon to add a new custom HTML form. The first thing the admins will have to do before users can draft approval documents is to add forms for use. Remember that MofficeSoft offers a variety of free sample forms for use that can be duplicated to your company's form box if desired. There are two types of form users can create: HTML forms or programming forms. The main difference between these two types of forms is that programming forms are meant to make calculations, as though they are imbued with Excel spreadsheet formulas and are thus a little trickier to set up. Here, let's create an HTML form first. Step 1. Register basic form information. We are first going to fill out the fields we see. First, let's start by selecting where we're going to put our file. Click the field entitled Form Selection and use the Form Section file tree to place the form you'll make to the appropriate folder. I'm creating a form to request for training workshops and will place my file in the Business Trip Forms folder. Afterward, I'm going to add a title to my form and a short description to help users know a little more about this form. Step 2. Organize information. Now, we're going to set up document preservation and numbering. Document preservation basically sets a time limit on how long the form will be in usage. Use the drop-down menus to decide the number of years and/or months for which the form should be available. If you want to keep this form forever, check the permanent box. Start editing document numbering by clicking on the pencil icon on the right-hand side of the Doc Number field. By default, MofficeSuite adds the name of the form, blank, the drafter's department code, more blanks, and the year. You can use the drop-downs to change the numbering format for each approval document made with this form. If you want to add a different title or words, simply write it down in the empty field you want to use, and it should appear for selection in the last field of the drop-down menu. Step 3. Add detailed form information. Now, we can add more detailed data about the form. In status, check to make sure the form is set to use, not do not use. Managers can likewise set up a default approval route with CC and reviewers, or allow the user to create and modify their own. Remember that the default approval route, CC, and reviewers will be the same for all users. Step 4. Create form with HTML code or editor. The final step of the HTML form is the coding. This portion requires your own HTML knowledge, so there's a limited amount of help we can give. To enter a prepared HTML code, simply switch the editor window to HTML mode and paste. You can check the appearance by switching back to editor mode. For Microsoft Office users, you can, however, import your Excel file to the editor for an automatically formatted HTML form. Simply click the Read Office File button below the editor window and upload your file from the bottom of the page. Finally, let's save and check our form in the All Forms list. Now, let's start creating a sample programming form. Remember, programming forms involve calculations. There are two methods to create a programming form: 1. Making a form using the existing forms, or 2. Creating a completely customized programming form. We'll go over both here. Creating from an existing sample programming form. To utilize one of the pre-existing templates to create a new programming form, first, go to the All Forms submenu and click the New Form button, as you would do to create a new HTML form. From the bottom of the text editor window, click the Programming Form button at a pop-up containing all the pre-existing programming templates offered by MofficeSoft, and any other programming forms you may have created will appear. Select any template and it will be called into the text editor for usage. Just fill in the rest of the above form details for usage and save to add the programming form to your list. Now, let's move on to the next submenu to create a customized programming form. Admins may add, edit, or delete any programming forms to the Programming Form submenu. Through the Registered tab, managers can view the forms list and subsequently disable, enable, or edit them. The New Form tab enables admins to modify the field names for current forms, as well as create and delete programming forms. Let's start creating our own custom programming form. There are a few steps to creating a customized programming form that we'll go through together. First, go to the New Form tab in the Programming Form submenu and click the plus button at the top right of the Form Input right-hand module. Enter the name of your form and table into the pop-up that appears. the other fields won't need adjusting. Now, you'll use the Fields icon on the top right-hand side of the Form Input module to add the fields that you'll need for your form. Click the icon to see a wide array of field types you can choose. Input box would most likely be the most useful for your forms. I'm going to add input box fields and two date fields for our example. Make sure you add labels. They are essential in identifying your fields. Note that I'll be using the total income, total expense, and profit loss fields later as sums for our calculations. After finishing adding the fields, click the Register button at the bottom to save. You'll be redirected to the Register tab of the Programming Form submenu. Now, you'll be making the HTML form needed for the visualization of the form. Note that you'll be able to use the checkbox to check and delete forms that you made. Checkboxes that are grayed out are the forms that are given by default. Now, let's click the title of our newly made form and set up an HTML form for it. Upon clicking, you'll notice a text editor window pop-up appear, as well as a button on the bottom that says Code View. Click the Code View button and the input forms made in the previous step will appear with some bizarre code between curly braces. To use the fields made in step 1, copy the code into the area of the HTML where the form drafter will need to enter the data required. Now, I'll paste in the HTML form I prepared by clicking on the HTML tab in the text editor. So here, you'll notice two spaces that mark the time period with year, month, and date. I'll replace each of these with the code for start date and end date at the bottom, respectively. I'll do this for the other amounts I marked with various zeros and replace them too. Then, finish by clicking Save with the top right-hand side button. Now, when you go back to the New Form tab and select our form from the list, you'll notice a magnifying glass icon in the Form Input module bar. Click it to preview the form and see how your fields became a part of the form. Now, for the real meat of the programming form, the calculations. From the New Form tab, select the form from the Form List module, and then click the calculator icon on the rightmost side of the Form Input module bar. We'll be creating three calculable fields: total income, which is the sum of all income fields, total expense, which is the sum of all expense fields, and finally profit loss, which will be the difference between the total income and total expense. Let's start with total income. Find the field and click the Edit button on the right-hand side of the field. A pop-up should appear wherein you can set up your formula. Write in a name for the formula and set Fix as No Use. Then, add the fields you'll be using by selecting the field from the drop-down list and clicking the plus sign. Note that you can only use arithmetic calculations of addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. After adding the fields, you'll notice the codes of each field appears at the bottom of Field Select with a drop-down menu of arithmetic operations and a delete button. Here is where you choose the operation that will appear after the field. We'll be using addition for this function, so we add all the fields together. For the last drop-down, we must finish the formula with end. Keep in mind that Moffice Suite does not allow for order of operations, and instead will carry out the formula from left to right. Select the number of decimal periods to use and save. We'll do the same thing for total expense as well. For profit loss, we'll subtract the total expense field from total income. Scroll up and go back to the list. Then go to the bottom of the page and click Register to complete and save changes. Finally, we're going to use the same method as previous to add the new programming form to our All Forms list for use. Now, if we decide to create a new form for approval using our new form, we can see the calculations in action. Not too hard. Let's continue going over the other approval admin menus. View all submitted approval documents through this submenu. Admins can see the basics of the draft, such as the approval route, title, date of creation, and how long completion took. This submenu allows for the creation of arbitrary decision makers. arbitrary decision makers are all powerful and will usually be C-level executives or management. Users added as arbitrary decision makers can approve or reject a document and have their decision end the approval process. Likewise, any draft an arbitrary decision maker submits will automatically complete upon submission. To add an arbitrary decision maker, simply select a user from the organization chart from the left module, and upon click, see that name be displayed on the list on the right-hand side module. Likewise, click the X button next to each name to remove them from the list. Click the Save button at the bottom of the right list module to register any changes made. Any users on the list on the right module for this submenu can, as its name suggests, change the approval route for any approval documents. Simply select the user from the organization chart on the left module and add, remove, or save changes as necessary. The Manage Approval Route submenu allows managers to create default approval routes that can be selected for a form. When creating or editing an approval form, managers can set its default approval route with the approval routes they add here. To register a new approval route, click the Create an Approval Route button. Herein, managers select the type of approval to use this route for, agreement or implementation, as well as a name for this route. In addition, admins will add users to the approval, reviewers, or CC refers. To edit an existing approval route, click the Edit button next to its name after the date column. Managers can likewise delete an existing approval route by checking the box next to its name and clicking the Delete button that appears. Through this submenu, view a list of past discarded approval documents. Click on a document's title to see its contents. Note that some content may not be visible without permissions. In the Official Documents submenu, managers can see approval documents that were registered as official documents for their company. View document details by clicking on a document's title. Used for signing documents such as official documents, this seal is a signature of your company. Insert text of adjustable sizes for headers and footers. Admins can also upload an image, ideally 70 pixels by 70 pixels, to use in conjunction with a signature. Let's move on to the user submenus for the approval menu. For normal users, you'll generally use the approval menu to draft approval documents or to read and sign off on others' drafts. We'll go over each of these actions, but first, we'll talk about the settings submenus to make using the forms a little easier. Manage approval route. If you know you'll be sending approval documents to certain people in a certain order frequently, it makes sense to prepare a few default approval routes to easily select when creating drafts. To set up a default approval route, go to Settings and then the Manage Approval Route submenu. Herein, click the Create a New Approval Route button and the form will appear. Decide whether the approval route will be for agreement or implementation approval types, and the name of the route, and the route itself, and any referrers or reviewers that you'd like to include. Click Save at the bottom to register. To organize completed approvals, create folders. Use the plus and minus buttons to add new folders or delete existing folders. To add documents to these folders, go to the Completed Approval submenu and check off the approvals you'd like to move. Then click More, then Copy, and finally select the folder to which you'd like to copy the approvals. Next, we have the Manage Department Folder submenu. Here, you can decide which department menus you'd like to see. Select any departments from the main organization list from the top module, and then click the plus button on the bottom selected department module to add it to the list. Then refresh the page and you can see that department folder and the selected departments inside. Finally, we have a few more personal touches we can add. Users can select a deputy user who will receive all the same approval documents you do. If you check off the deputy approval permission, that user can approve documents on your behalf as well. This is particularly useful when going on an extended vacation. Next, you can also set up users with permission to read for users from the organization chart who will always have read permissions for your approval documents. This is convenient for superiors who may constantly require knowledge of documents you draft. Lastly, we have the signature image. Here, upload an image file of your signature that can be used in approval documents. Optimally, it should be a GIF, PNG, or JPG file up to 100 kilobytes and 65 by 40 pixels. For mobile app users, you can access this submenu on the Moffice Collaboration app and handwrite your signature with your mobile device for easy upload. Now, we'll move on to user actions in regard to the approval menu. Here, we'll learn how to draft an approval document. Go to the In Progress submenu and click the pencil icon to create a new approval draft. Let's break down the selections. Step 1. Approval type, agreement versus implementation route. First, select which approval to use, agreement or implementation. Are you seeking just approval? Click Agreement. For those who need actions to be done immediately upon final confirmation, select Implementation. However, note you'll need to know what forms your company places where to find the location of the form you require. Step 2. Select a form. This step is pretty self-explanatory. First, choose the appropriate category and select the form you desire, and it will be displayed in the text editor below. Form details will likewise appear if the approval manager entered a description for the form. Step 3. Set up an approval route, reviewers, and referrers. There are three approval route options. The first one is set up by administrators. Some forms may have required default approval routes that you must use, in which case you don't need to do anything. Second, you can use any default approval routes from the drop-down menu that appears, which you should have already set up in the Settings submenu. Aside from that, you can customize the approval route to your liking. Click the Organization Chart button and check the managers to add for approval. Click the plus sign at the bottom of the window to add them to the selected list and use the up and down arrows to rearrange their order. Note that the top individual should be yourself and the bottom most individual will be the final approver. Click Save after you finish. We'll use the same method to add referrers and reviewers, though the order doesn't matter here. Remember that reviewers can only review the approval document after its completion, while referrers can read your draft every step of the way. Step 4, additional details. Finally, to complete the draft, enter the title, add file attachments, and fill in any parts of the form below that require input. During this process, you can always save to drafts submenu from the top button or preview how the document looks. When you're ready, click the submit button. Step 5, submission options. When you submit the draft, you'll be met with a pop-up for a few extra sending options. Add a priority to the approval mail you send to everyone in the approval route. Likewise, drafters can choose to use and set up a due date for urgent matters. For added privacy, make the approval route private so only those with the document can see its contents. Likewise, you can make a secure approval so anyone who wishes to access the draft must enter their secondary security password. Finally, add opinions and comments as needed before you send off your draft. And that's all there is to it! Editing an approval. After sending an approval, you can confirm it through the Submitted submenu under In Progress. Click on the approval to check contents and access additional options. The first button you may notice is the Cancel Submissions. You can choose to cancel your approval up until its final confirmation. You may also edit the privacy settings, content, attachments, approval route, reviewers, and referrers. Scroll down to the bottom of the page, and you can add additional comments and save them with the document. For other options, users can save and download the approval to their computer, save to archive, view the document flow, which displays timestamps of when the document was approved and by whom, view version history, so users can see previous versions of the document, and check views to see who looked at the draft and when. Those who prefer physical documents can likewise print the entirety of the approval draft or just the form content. Approving a document is simple as well. To check on any approvals that may need your sign-off immediately or in the near future, go to either Received and To Receive submenus respectively. Click on an approval to see the editing options and the Decide button. A pop-up will appear wherein users choose whether to approve or reject the document or put it on hold. If you're an arbitrary decision maker, you can also use that to finish the approval process here as well. Note that any decision you make will send email notifications to others in the approval route and referrers. To reject an approval, a reason needs to be written in the comment section in the window. Likewise, rejected approvals may be resubmitted and then edited before submission for easy changes. Head to the For Reference menu for approvals that you are connected to in regards to referrers and reviewers. Here, there are three submenus for various purposes. Use the CC Referrer submenu to view documents wherein the drafter selected you as a CC referrer for the document. In the For My Review submenu, read over documents for which the drafter selected you as a reviewer. Finally, the For Others Review lets you see a list of documents in which you selected one or more users as reviewers. Finally, for completed approvals, you can utilize many of the previous options with an additional option, Official Documentation. For approvals that signify some official company-wide significance, select your form from the completed submenu and go to Other and then Official Documentation. From the Official Documentation settings, you can decide a style for the text in the header and footer, add company information, and add additional document information. After saving, the form can be emailed to others or notified to internal employees. If the approval admin registered a company official seal, it will also appear in the bottom. That's it! Thank you for watching this Moffice Guide video. Please subscribe to our channel for more content and like our video if it helped you. Until next time, have an outstanding day!